21 bridges is falling down, falling down, falling down. 21 bridges is falling down, my fair viewer. Build it up with a better script, better script, better script. Build it up with a better script, my fair viewer. Giving it a decent plot wouldn't hurt, wouldn't hurt. Please give it a decent plot, my fair viewer. You're also going to need to do something about the absolutely pathetic runtime, wasted central idea, and a truly predictable one-dimensional bunch of characters as well. And aside from that, tis all good. Which isn't to say that the central idea is bad, because it isn't. I mean, an embattled NYPD detective being thrust into a citywide manhunt for a pair of cop killers after uncovering a massive and unexpected conspiracy sounds awesome. The setup's pretty awesome as well. I mean, you've got everything here for a cracking old-school cop thriller along the lines of the Steve McQueen classic Bullet, just without as good a car chase, because no cop film will ever have as good a car chase as Bullet. Or even something like a really miniaturized version of The Fugitive.
I didn't kill my wife! I don't care!
Because, believe you me, you've got the ingredients here for something amazing. I mean, you've got a cop with a rep being teamed up with a new partner, being forced to track down a pair of cop killers whilst tugging on the threads of a conspiracy whilst they're all trapped on an island until dawn, at which point the bridges will be reopened and all the rats will escape into the ether. Imagine what you could do with that. Allegiances being tested, bonds broken, a ticking clock hurting everyone, the pressure rising as the public become angrier and angrier as they realise more and more they're being held hostage by a massive game of hide and seek. You've got the cast for it as well, with Black Panther as the lead, backed up by J. Jonah Jameson holding the politicians at bay, Sienna Miller as his partner, and even Taylor Kitsch, thankfully, long past Hollywood's delusion that he was the next big thing, getting some work. Now, all of this could work if the film was allowed the time to breathe. And I know that most Hollywood films are in dire need of another trip to the editing suite, but this? By my watch, the film had reached a natural conclusion after a truly pathetic 82 minutes, and then pottered along for another 10 because it had to reveal the most obvious plot twist since I asked my allegedly full wife where my chips kept vanishing off to. I mean, 82 minutes would have worked if this was the setup to a TV series where Black Panther would realise that although he smashed his tentacle by accident, the rest of the vampire squid is still out there, hidden in plain sight. But this isn't an opening episode of a TV show. This is an alleged feature-length film. And all of this film's issues can be traced back to the runtime. Look, Hollywood, I know that there are loads of kids out there who need make stuff go boom every 2 minutes, but there are a few adults left in the world of film lovers who would have loved a film taking its time, because more time means more developed characters. As is what we know about these people in the first 10 minutes, it's all we ever know about them, which makes what I guess are supposed to be twists and turns fall completely flat, which in a film like this is pretty a big hit to take. You've got our alleged villains being directed to villains as helpers who appear to have wandered in from an episode of The Blacklist and helped them when there is no way they would lift a finger in the real world. Then you have the fact this film is just action scene after action scene after action scene, which are pretty dull with very little time dedicated to actual detective work. Interrogating suspects, dead ends, busted leads, or even the fact that the clock is ticking and the politicians will be getting antsy. Or, as our snarky film types say,
there is no tension in this film.
And it just blows my mind. I mean, I know that this is the director's first, and hopefully last, excursion to the silver screen, but surely someone somewhere could have pointed out the fact that films like this need to breathe. Hmm? Oh, you thought this film was directed by those guys who made Avengers Endgame? Aren't you adorable? I'm afraid their lovely marketable names merely get a producer credit, and I have yet to understand what that means, if indeed it means anything at all. No, the director is some guy called Brian Kirk, who has done purely TV series up until this point, which actually explains a lot. The best I can say about 21 Bridges is that it's a very good idea, which has been completely and utterly devastated by a pointless decision to go for the people who need an explosion every 5 minutes, instead of people who just want a good old cop thriller. It doesn't need any work done to its cast, but developing the characters would have helped. Bringing in some tension would have helped. A longer runtime would have helped. Doing some work on the plot would have helped. Making the twists actually twisty would have helped as well. Aside from those little nuggets, yeah, film of the year, woohoo! So absolutely skip it. But what did you guys think? And what is your favourite old school cop thriller? Comment below, let me know. I'm Daniel, Spinner Dunking. If you've enjoyed this video, please like, share and subscribe.